When does that come out? November?
Carlos Tevez. Looking to stretch the defense one way, then the other.
What's that going to be? Sometimes they fall behind and they have to delay the release because sometimes they make a promise and they can't keep it. This happened with Mass Effect. Mass Effect had to do that. So did Batman Arkham Knight. When those two games... Well, Mass Effect hasn't come out yet, but the new Mass Effect, they had to delay the release date because they just weren't able to get it done in time. They didn't have the materials to get it done right away, so they had to postpone it a little bit. And for Batman Arkham Knight, they had to push the release date back like half a year to a year because they just wanted to make sure they got the game made right. Which I was okay with them pushing the date back because they got the game made right. That's what matters to me is when they get the game right. I don't care if they have to take forever to release the game. As long as the game is made correctly and was worth the wait, then go ahead and do it. But I don't like it when they just, you know, they're quick to release a game. They want to try to release as quick as possible, but then the quality is just not there. That's when I get really frustrated. Argentina's a good team.
It'll be an Argentinian corner. Pastore didn't stretch the keeper.
Michael, he saved my ass. Gore, how's it going? How you doing today? Do you want to play me in a FIFA match after this? Or do you just want to watch and just chill? It's up to you.
This is Theo Walcott. Session has been given up here. Di Maria.
I'm talking to my viewer. That's alright. Yeah, it was just a spare the moment kind of thing. Yeah, that's fine. You can watch if you want. No worries.
It's a corner for Argentina. Men coming forward.
Away. Come on, let's get a goal off of this.
Can he go through himself?
Let's go England.
Crucial goal has put England in front.
How did I miss that easy goal? I thought that was in. I totally screwed that up. But we're going to make this right. Oh, yeah, by kicking it right to the goalkeeper. Of course. Come on, Ricky, get on sides. I really want to make puppy chow again. I really miss eating puppy chow. That stuff is so good.
Di Maria.
Yeah, you'll be able to do that when you get your own place, I'm sure. Hopefully. Of course, you're going to have to save money, though, for, like, you know, your appliances first. Microwave, toaster. Yeah, I know. Well, yeah, you just kind of slowly grind at it, gradually.
Intercepted well, read his opponent's mind there. Lionel Messi.
Usually when the rent is cheaper, though, they have, actually, that's not always true, but some, you would think it would be true, though. You know, with lower rent, they'll have higher expectations for you to get the rent on time, but eh, sometimes it's not the case. We're pretty lucky, though. My landlord, you could be, like, 2 or 3 weeks late on the... You're not 2 or 3 weeks. You could be, like, 2 weeks late on the rent, and they don't care. Ours is really nice though. Like he seriously is really nice. Like when my mom was going through all the issues when my aunt passed away, he's like, yeah, whenever you get the money, that's fine. He's like, if you're a month late on the rent, don't worry about it. He didn't seem to mind. I was telling my mom, yeah, we probably shouldn't move for a while then because we have a really nice landlord. Anytime you get a good landlord, you should stick around if you can, because that's just hard to come by these days. Oh, nice. That's dirt cheap. That's dirt cheap by today's standards. I'm playing like crap today.
Referee has indicated how much stoppage time there will be.
I'm not even halfway through the game and Sterling's already tired. Are you kidding me? Wow. These players are old.
And Saldi.
Barely used him in this match and he's already tired. Dude needs to hit the frickin' gym. I'll see if maybe if my mom will let us go to Hankerson's tomorrow and get some donuts. There's only one Hankerson's in the world, and you know where it is. It There's only one way you can get Anchor Sins, but you're not gonna like the answer. You gotta come to West Bend, exactly. Or when I get a job, if when I get a job and I come over to visit you, then you just tell me to buy the Hankersons for you. Just tell me what you want. If you can remember what you like from Hankersons, that is. Yeah, I know, I remember that. I'm just like, man, you're so boring. Custard Filt's better, but it's cool. I would honor your request just because you asked me to. Just because you asked.
Seeking out Messi.
No, they don't. There are other bakeries in Wisconsin that are pretty similar to Hankersons in like quality and taste of the donuts, but still nobody compares. Like, they're close, but they're just not quite there. Like, the custard and some of the other donut places. Like, I would say La Crosse probably has the second best bakery. The second best would be La Crosse, Wisconsin. Trying to win the World Cup, damn it. Trying to get to the World Cup first. That's half the battle, just getting to the World Cup. Then we gotta win. Great. Argentina got me. I'm not even like playing my best either. I'm like just kind of playing like crap today. One and done. That's a one and done thing. One and done. Never again. Too much money invested and not going enough times to justify it. I don't go often enough that I can justify it.
His role played there, Clive. That's a lovely finish.
The sort of goal you can watch over and over again, isn't it? Close game this one, but England are ahead.
Yeah. I got a new blender. I had to buy myself a new blender. My blender wasn't very good. Or my mom's blender kind of broke, so I got a new blender.
And Saldi.
Yep, so I got one of those utilities taken care of. If I ever get my own place, I got my blender already. Got that taken care of.
Big chance! Oh, that took some stopping. License flagged offside.
Offside.
Did an earlier pass.
Well, that runs too late. He's gone far too early.
What? He wasn't even offsides. He wouldn't be offsides unless his foot touched down past the red line. I didn't see anybody offsides. This game is just full of shit. Nobody was offsides on that play. This game's just being a dick. Wow. That was deflected. That's a corner. But they're going to call it a goal kick. Because they're assholes. That was totally a corner. And they just blew that call. Wow.
Save. This will be a corner to England.
Corner to England. We'll see what they can make of it.
But he's hit on the ball. He's capable of much better than that. Oh, that's a dreadful effort. There's no need to try it from there. And that's miles wide. The goalkeeper, no problem.
Yeah, I like their chocolate custard filled Long Johns and Hankersons, and their caramel Persians are my new favorite now. I mean, they got good chocolate Persians too, but chocolate Persians without nuts are good, but I like the caramel Persians without nuts better. They taste better. Dude, there's always going to be something you have to give up, though, Ben. There's always going to be certain places that you live in your life, and then you switch cities, and you're just like, man, I miss that.
This is Gary Cahill. for Rooney.
He's like, I just want my Hankersons. You gotta bring it to me. Be like, yeah, Ben, but do you got the money on you? I don't, you asshole. Fuck. Screw you. He's like, what? He's like, it's not fair, man. I really miss having an A&W because West Bend used to have an A&W and then there was a fire. I didn't miss that goal by much. I keep missing easy shots. This is embarrassing. That's the one thing I'm going to miss like crazy, though. If I ever leave West Bend, I'm going to miss Hankersons. It's never going to be the same. I'm never going to be able to eat donuts the rest of my life unless I have Hankersons. That's what I'm talking about with Hankersons. Like, once you've had Hankersons, you never want to eat donuts ever again after you're forced to give up donuts. It just doesn't taste the same. Even if you get the honey bun donuts at gas stations are alright, but it's like, but I want Hankersons. Come on, Hankersons, give me the family secret recipe so I can make it on my own. You know, right? Come on, what's the family recipe? I know, right? Not happening. A guy can try, right? But that's just one thing you could miss, though. But if you had to give up Hankersons so you could have better fast food places to eat at, I would totally sacrifice Hankersons. Because that's just one place. If you could give up a Hankersons so you could have A&W whenever you want and have all those like places at the mall in Green Bay that are better than West Bend food, I would totally take it. Hell yeah.
Switching the point of the attack. Terrific pass.
Once I get out of debt, I could probably move to Green Bay, probably. I just need to get out of debt first, but once I have my medical bills paid off, I'll probably move to Green Bay if you want. It's going to be challenging at first, though, because I'm going to have to get a job, so I'm going to have to... It's going to be tough at first.
Goal.
I'm working on it. Wow, what if I did have it?
Game over. England have pretty much tied this one up. Theo Walcott has it for England. It was an apology for a challenge by the defender. It's got to do more. He's got men with him. It'll be a throw into England.
Changes and like changing people's tires, that simple stuff.
Just put his foot through that clearance. He's got a chance. Sergio Aguero.
I forgot I had four goals. I'm sitting here thinking it's still 2-1 or 3-1. Ooh, I got away with it because it was off ball. Nice. Oh, that was too much power. Didn't need it. The other team needs the goals, not me. I miss A&W, though. I love A&W. Mushroom and Swiss burgers are the best. And the cheese curds. Oh, my goodness. They're so good. Di Maria. I might get Rocky Rococo's though for my birthday. Rocky Rococo's pizza. They got great pizza. I know that they should have a Rocky somewhere close to Green Bay. They should have a Rocky somewhere. I'm pretty sure they have one. I don't know if it's in Green Bay or if it's like if they got one in De Pere or not. But I mean, I don't think De Pere's got one. But I think somewhere in Green Bay, maybe in Ashwaubenon, they might have one. Yeah. That's my favorite pizza place in the whole wide world. The problem is, if I ever left Wisconsin, I'd have to say goodbye to Rocky Rococo's, and I'd be really sad if that happened. Really, really sad. Be like, no, I don't want to give up Rocky Rococo's. I can't do it. To move to Mids. Ow. Damn it, that hurt. I can move to Minnesota. They have a Rockies in Minnesota. Oh, great. I got to play Germany in the championship round. Perfect. Because I just love playing Germany. Where? Alright, my third season. I had to give up Rocky Rococo's. I'd have to give up. Oh man, just too much to give up. Maybe I should stay in Wisconsin. Are a lot higher in other states. A lot higher. Wisconsin's one of the worst places you can... Wisconsin's one of the worst places when it comes to job opportunities. We lost a lot of jobs. Nobody wants to really work in Wisconsin anymore. And a lot of people are just more successful. A lot of people are just more successful when they don't live in Wisconsin. Lots more job opportunities everywhere else. Lots more. Minnesota, Detroit, and Wisconsin are all states that are not very successful when it comes to jobs, or having a lot of jobs, I should say. We don't really have a lot of success. Illinois is kind of eh. Illinois is alright. I mean, Illinois had its problems too, though. But most of the opportunities are in the big cities, though. I mean, anywhere, really, but, you know, New York and California and Florida, those are like all the big booming places to work, really. you want to make the money. You want to make the good money. Plus, if you were a butler, if you worked as a butler for a rich family, you'd make a lot of money. You have, like, almost no life, but you'd make a lot of money. I mean, they pay you a really good salary. You get benefits and everything. Yeah, I know, it's part of the job, but sometimes they'll pay you extra money not to say anything. Sometimes they will. Don't want to play Barcelona and Real Madrid. They got that Italy team, it's really good. But the other league's got SCB. Play an Invitational Cup. This should be the World Cup season. It's just gotta beat Germany. Yeah, go ahead. Have a good night. Yeah. Oh, you got tomorrow off? No, you gotta work tomorrow, I think. Oh, yeah, you mean at nighttime. Sorry. Okay. You're like, you don't care, I'm going to bed anyways, so go ahead and fix it. Alright, sounds good. Da 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 da. See you later. Have a good one. Yeah, I know. See you later.
questions. Can really get some distance on these. Here's Adam Lallana. Lam. Lam. Gundogan. Didn't look their place. A bit untidy at times.
It is, and it's careless, isn't it? Because they're in a good position there.
They lose it here if he's not careful. He's taking a good strike. Oh, that's a really good save. It's going to be a corner to England. What can they make of it? They were exposed there, and he got up well to take full advantage.
He makes finishing with his head look very easy.
That's why you practice your set pieces, Clive. You do them till they're imprinted in your brain, literally. That's a great finish.
It's a goal that's put England ahead in this one, just where they want to be.
Hey, what's up? What's going on?
Wilshire. He's got options.
Thanks for watching my stream. How you doing today? how's your week going? You watch FIFA at all? Are you a big fan of FIFA? Is there any FIFA teams that you support that you like to watch? Russian? Are you right? Oh, are you saying you're Russian? That's cool if you're Russian. Like, that's totally cool with me. That's cool. Do you support the Russian FIFA team? That's cool with me. They're a pretty alright team. They're pretty good. They can be pretty good sometimes. They can be a pretty good team. I kind of like rooting for underdog teams in FIFA all the time, so. Oh, no, you're not. My bad. I'm sorry. Misunderstanding. Sorry about that. Misunderstanding. My bad. Sorry about that. Oh, wait. Are you saying your name is Russ? Are you trying to tell me your name is Russ, or? I'm confused. I don't know. Don't mind me. I'm just staying up late tonight. Yeah. Just can't sleep, so I'm just streaming because I can't sleep right now, so. My uncle's not doing too well, so I gotta go visit my uncle tomorrow, because we don't know how long he's got left, so I gotta go see my uncle one last time tomorrow and say my goodbyes, because I don't know if he's gonna survive or not, or if he's not gonna make it, so I'm gonna go see my uncle tomorrow. Hopefully he'll be okay. Hey, I got a family that lives in England. I love England. England's a nice place. I really do like England a lot. I'm a huge fan of England. I really want to see England so badly too when I go visit my sister. She just recently married a guy that's from England, so she just got her visa accepted a year ago. So this is her first year living in England. So when I get the money, I'm gonna save up and visit my sister in England first chance I get. But yeah, I really do. I like people that are from the UK and Europe, just Europe in general, because a lot of the Europeans that I've met are really nice people. They're just really genuine people, and they're really nice to talk to, and they're great people overall. So I like Europeans a lot because they've been nice to me, so I'm generally nice to them back because I've had good experiences. I got a couple of friends that are from England that I met playing online video games, and Europeans are great people, so. Okay, so basically, you're from England, but your nationality and your family is basically Russian. I got it. Okay, that's cool. Yeah, I'm like 75% Polish and 25% German, I think. Something like that.
Let's fly! Radar wasn't working there, was it?
Thanks for watching my stream, by the way, and I hope you're having a good week. You having a good summer so far?
Just headed on. Gundogan.
Oh, never mind. I got it wrong again. My bad. Sorry. Never mind. I don't know. I'm just trying to piece this together. Never mind. You might have just been sarcastic. Oh, no. You were sarcastic when you said I'm so Russian. Sorry, my bad. My bad for getting that wrong. Sorry about that. Just don't mind me. I'm a little bit tired today. Don't mind what I'm saying. I'm just having a rough week, so I'm just trying to have a better week, really. Just hoping my uncle can pull through. It's really hard losing two family members in the same year, so I hope he can pull through. He's my only uncle on my dad's side of the family, too. He's my only uncle, so... Yeah, Barcelona. I like Barcelona. They're a good team. I like Barcelona. I'm a huge Neymar fan. I like Neymar. I'm a huge Neymar fan, and that's why I like Barcelona, is because I'm a Neymar fan. Man City. I also like Manchester City as well. I like Aguero or whatever his name is. I like Aguero a lot. And I like David Silva. David Silva is another player I like on Manchester City, so. And they got Sterling. I like Sterling as well, so. Yeah, I like Manchester City as well. But, honestly, I got a lot of teams I like in FIFA. I like Manchester City. I like Manchester United. I like Liverpool. I like, Well, okay, never mind. I used to like Liverpool. I don't really like Liverpool as much anymore, but I used to like Liverpool a lot before they went in a negative direction. But I do like Man City and United still. But yeah, those two, Barcelona, I like. No, I don't really like Real Madrid at all. No, actually, never mind about that. I don't really like Ronaldo because he's very cocky and arrogant, so I don't like Ronaldo at all, but I do like Modric. He's just on the wrong team. But if we're going to talk about like international teams, like what countries do I root for during the World Cup, I would have to say I really like Germany a lot. I root for Germany the most. Occasionally, I'll root for Spain. But Germany and Team USA, because, you know, I'm from the United States, so obviously I like Team USA for that reason, but Team USA and Germany are my top two teams, and I also like Italy. Italy is my third favorite. Those are the three national teams I support, Italy, Germany, and the U.S. Not really a Portugal fan, though, just because of Ronaldo, but it is an England throw. Yeah, Iniesta's a good player. I like Iniesta. Messi's alright. I'm not really against or for him. I just lost a little bit of respect for Messi because of the tax fraud evasion that he got involved with FIFA. He got investigated and he was found guilty of tax fraud, tax evasion, so that's the only reason I kind of lost respect for Messi, but I still kind of root for him once in a while when he's playing. Who will get the golden ball? That's a good question. I really don't know who's going to get the golden ball. That one could go to anybody, really. That's a good question. That really is a good question to ask. I have no idea. But... let me ask you something, though. Is the Golden Ball, is that like the MVP award for FIFA? Because the National Football League and the National Basketball Association, NBA, and the NFL, they have this thing that we call the Most Valuable Player Award. So I guess I would have to ask you, is Golden Ball like the MVP award for soccer, like the most valuable player in soccer, or football, what you call it in Europe? I think if they had an MVP award for FIFA, it could be, like, I could easily see Messi or Ronaldo getting the Golden Ball award if that was an MVP award. I could see it going to Messi or Ronaldo either way, because they're just the top players in the league, really. But I think it would be super cool if Neymar could get the award. That would be pretty cool. I gotta tell you one thing though, my favorite FIFA player is definitely gotta be Aubameyang. He is definitely my favorite player, and he plays for Dortmund on Germany, that yellow Dortmund team. I don't know how to pronounce it, but he plays for this yellow German team called Dortmund or whatever. And his name is Aubameyang, and he's my favorite FIFA player of all time. I love watching Aubameyang play. He's a great player. I also like Royce. Royce is one of my other favorite players, and he's on the German national team. Royce is my absolute favorite. I absolutely love watching Royce play. And I also like Milner. Milner on the Germany team. Milner's pretty good. So I like him as well. Ozil, however you pronounce that, is pretty good.
Great to see the skipper getting forward, Clive, into the danger areas and knocking himself a goal.
Yeah, Barcelona though, they're a really good team. If they don't win the championship for their league, I definitely say if they don't win it, it's going to be Real Madrid. Those two are like the top dogs in their league. I love watching Barcelona play though. Well, that's how a lot of FIFA players are. I have to agree, Neymar can definitely be an asshole sometimes. I definitely agree with you. I'm just a fan of Neymar's skills, though. I'm not really a fan of him off the field. I don't really respect Neymar off the field, but you know how it goes sometimes. You know, you don't like a player off the field, but sometimes you're just a fan of how the person plays the game, I guess. But I only like Neymar for his skills. I don't really care for how he treats people off the field.
Not short of options here. Oh, this is a chance. Didn't trouble the goalkeeper.
I will say this though, I really do like I think his name is Wayne Rooney. Yeah, Rooney. Well, his last name is Rooney. I like Rooney as well. Rooney's a nice guy. I like Rooney on and off the field. He's a nice, genuine person. So I do like watching him play sometimes. Dang it.
Chances are coming, Clive.
Substitution for England. Interesting.
Ronaldo is a really, really overconfident asshole. Ronaldo was talking a lot of shit to Iceland because I think Ronaldo was just jealous because Iceland just played a good game against Portugal. I think Ronaldo's just pissed because he couldn't make any goals against Iceland. Iceland played really good soccer against Portugal. And I think Ronaldo's just, you know, he really is a diva when it comes to FIFA. Ronaldo has to be the biggest prima donna diva in all of FIFA sports for soccer. He really is all about him. Like, if Ronaldo doesn't score the game-winning goal and somebody else scores the goal, or if he doesn't contribute to his team when they win, you know, Ronaldo's always got to make the sport about him. Even when he's not contributing. And I just don't think it's right. Like, I don't like Ronaldo for that reason, because Ronaldo will sit there. Like, I'll give you an example. UEFA Euro. The UEFA Euro tournament that just recently took place. You know, Portugal beat France for the UEFA Euro championship. And I didn't like the fact that Ronaldo was bragging that his team won it and taking all the credit when Ronaldo didn't deserve any credit. Ronaldo didn't do a damn thing to help Portugal win the championship. And he just sits there and he acts like it was all him. And he's acting like he's the reason they won UEFA Euro. It's like, no, it's not. You know, Ronaldo didn't do anything in the championship game really to help them. He just got injured at the wrong time, but he didn't really help them win it. But a lot of people don't like Ronaldo because he's just a cocky, arrogant, self-centered prick. It's what he really is. It's always about Ronaldo, and if Ronaldo doesn't get his way, he just acts like a big baby about it, and he has to make everything about him. That's why I don't like Ronaldo. I'm playing on semi-pro right now, to be honest, just because it's so late and I'm really tired and I just don't have the energy to play on professional. I usually play on professional difficulty, but because I'm tired right now, I just don't have the energy to play on professional, so I just decided to play on semi-pro instead. but yeah, this is on semi-professional difficulty.
I'm sure the next time he gets an opportunity, he'll hit the target.
I'll take the free corner.
Always dangerous at corners. Wilshere! Got to play through to the final whistle. That wasn't a good effort.
No, he's got that all wrong, I'm afraid, Clive. And he's let them off, basically, there. That's a waste.
What language is that? I don't really speak that language. I only speak one language. I'm sorry. I'm monolingual. I only speak one language. I'm sorry. It's just because I'm not really good at learning foreign languages. I was trying to learn how to speak Spanish when I was in high school, but I guess I have a learning disability, kind of. So I'm not really good at retaining information when I try to learn foreign languages. So I apologize that I don't speak the other language that you speak, so I'm sorry about that. But trust me, if I could learn how to speak more languages, I would definitely be open to learning other languages. Just dealt a crappy hand, I guess you could say. It is what it is, though, but... Thanks for watching, though. I mean, I appreciate you watching my stream today. Thanks for watching. And I hope you have a really good summer, and I hope you have a good week this week, and hopefully you can have a nice, exciting week and have some fun this week, hopefully. Hope things will be awesome and everything for you. I hope, is there anything cool going on in England right now? Oh yeah, thanks, I appreciate it. Thank you for Thank you for following me on YouTube. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you. Appreciate it. So, yeah, my other question here is there anything exciting going on in England right now, wherever you're from? Like, whatever part of England you're from, I should say. Is there any exciting, like, festivals going on? Oh, yeah, I can do more streams if you want. I stream almost every day. I stream almost every single day when I play on my PlayStation 4. I stream this all the time, so... But if you want me to stream on YouTube more than on Twitch, because I stream on Twitch and YouTube when I play FIFA. But I could start streaming on YouTube if you want, though, if you want to watch more of these games. I could definitely do that for you, no problem. No problem at all. But, Wow, my team is terrible. Are you kidding me? My best defensive player gets injured. Dang it all. Darn it all. Alright, oh well. Yeah, I'll try to do more streams for you so you can watch them. Do you like any other games? Like, do you like Batman games? The superhero Batman? I have Batman Arkham Knight. I could stream that for you. Let me show you the games I got, maybe. So I got Madden 16. This is Madden 16. I have that. I have baseball, MLB The Show 16. I have hockey NHL 16. I don't know if you follow basketball at all, but I got NBA 2K16. It's a basketball game I got. I have Rock Band 4, if you like Rock Band games. I got that. I got got Grand Theft Auto 5. Grand Theft Auto 5, this is. I have that as well. I have, I got Star Wars Battlefront. Got Star Wars, if you like that. If you like Star Wars games. You know, I got all kinds of games. I got Call of Duty. I got The Division. I got The Division. Tom Clancy's The Division. And Call of Duty Black Ops 3 I got. Those are the games I got. Oh, that's cool. You're a goalie. Are you any good? So, are you any good at goalie? Like, do you play? I can't talk today. Let me rephrase the question here. Do you play football in real life? Like, are you a real life football player? Like, are you a goalie in real life? Is what I'm asking. And I'm just curious how good you are. Shoot, if I lived in England and you were in a football match, I would totally go to watch you play and support your team. I'd be a fan. I'd be a fan and help support your team if you played for a real life football club. I love watching my friends play sports, so. Yeah, if I ever do go in the England area and you're playing a football match, you know, I can come and support your team if you want. Just gotta let me know the details. Ah, okay, that's cool. Buffon, I don't know how to pronounce that. I apologize if I mispronounced this guy's name. Is that Buffon? Buffon? I don't know how to pronounce that, but I apologize for misspelling that. I apologize. Yeah, is he a real life player though? That you like? I don't know.
Mario Marchisio in towards Mandzukic. Mandzukic! You can understand why he's kept going for goal, having scored in the game. But this one has passed him by.
Yeah, I don't think you can knock him for having a go from there. He's in a good position.
No, I do not know that guy either. I'm sorry. The two players that you have mentioned, I'm sorry, but I don't know who they are. I'm sorry, I don't. No, I don't. I don't know them. No. No, I don't. I'll be honest with you. I'm going to be real with you. I'm going to be really honest with you right now when I say this. I follow FIFA a little bit. I follow FIFA a little bit, but I don't follow FIFA a lot. In other words, I do follow some of the players. Like in the Barclays League, I follow them. And a few other players in the German League and the Spanish League and Major League Soccer, I follow them, but I'll have to look up those players though on Google. I'll have to look them up for sure, yes. I'll have to look them up. I kind of watch American football more. I'm more of a American football. That's my sport. I like American football a lot. That's my sport that I watch the most. And I watch a lot of basketball too. Basketball is my second favorite sport. So I'm really excited about Team USA in the Summer Olympics for Team USA basketball. Pretty excited for them this year.
He's gone for it, flashed a boot at it, really.
I think he's unlucky there, you know, because he didn't have any time. The defenders were closing down, so he had to take it early.
this Italian team is kicking my ass right now. Hello, thank you for watching my stream. Second person that's joined, thank you. How are you doing today?
Good clean tackle.
I hope you're having a good day today. Thanks for watching. Hope everybody's doing good today. I gotta play better right now. I used to have a Skype account, yes, but I don't remember my Skype name, so I'm gonna have to probably do a security question check on my Skype so I can get my Skype information back again. I do have a Skype though, yes. And if I have to, I can always make another Skype account too. I'm assuming that you might want to Skype with me. I'm assuming that's why you're asking if I got a Skype account. Man, this team is kicking my butt. Jesus, Goy is saving everything. I cannot lose this game. If I lose this game, I'm gonna have to avenge my team. This is ridiculous. I'm playing terrible today. Oh, come on, ref. The dude is trying to take me out on my knees. Is there anybody on this team that can score goals?
Tries to punch it away.
Come on, Clint Dempsey.
Shot's on here. That's a decent shot.
Dang it. Come on, Clint Dempsey. I took you out of the retirement league so I could put you in a good league, and this is how you repay me? By missing open shots, Dempsey? Come on, Clint Dempsey. Really, the Major League Soccer really is a retirement league because all the old players are always in Major League Soccer for some reason. We gotta clear the ball here. We gotta go. Come on, guys. We gotta score. Give it to Ricky. Yeah, give it to Ricky. How do you miss that shot?
Manchester United have won a corner. And that's dealt with the problem.
Come on.
Got a shot off now.
How is that not a handball? Come on.
Well, if you look at the coaching manual, shot off, and he's done it.
There we go. We got one goal back. Let's see if we can tie it at 2 apiece at the half here.
Today
and
to find the bottom right, brilliant.
We restart the game 2-1. Oh, yeah, I know I sound like a hypocrite, right? Because I support the Italian football team, and he's probably Buffon is probably a player in an Italian league, so I probably sound like a hypocrite, right? Because it's like, oh yeah, I like Italy, but yeah, I've never heard of the Italian league players. I'll be honest, the real reason I like Italy is because they won the World Cup in 2008, and that's when I first followed FIFA. I was really, 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 really pissed off at France because there was this player named Zidane. His name was Zidane, and he played for France, and the guy headbutted another player in the World Cup tournament. He headbutted, I don't know if it was a German player, or no. Yeah, he headbutted an Italian player, and he got suspended for headbutting an Italian player for the Italian team in the World Cup back in 2008. And this guy's name is Zidane, and he's a very cocky, arrogant player at the time. And I was rooting for Italy because I could not stand France at the time because I didn't like Zidane. But, yeah, I like Italy as a country, like as a nation. I support them, but I don't really know much about Italian players. No, I mean, it's okay too. Like, if people want to say I'm not a real Italian fan, you know, I'll be the first person to admit I'm not a true fan of Italy when it comes to FIFA. I kind of root for them, I guess. I root for Italy, like, on the side, really. Like, if Germany's not doing well and Team USA, if they're both not in it, I root for Italy as, like, my other team, if nobody else does well. I'll admit, I'm kind of like an Italian. When it comes to Italy, I'm a fair weather fan, and I'll admit that. I'll come out to you and be honest with you. I kind of am a fair weather fan when it comes to that. But Germany and Team USA, I will root for them no matter how good or bad they are, because I've always loved rooting for Germany because because it's part of my nationality. My nationality, because I'm 25% German, so I always root for Germany for that reason. And I'm from the United States, so obviously that's why I like Team USA. But yeah. It's okay if you think I'm not a real Italian fan. I agree with you. I have to agree with you because it's true. I have to agree with you, so. Hey, Andy, how you doing today? Thanks for watching my stream, Andy. Appreciate it, man. I'm kind of just streaming FIFA 16 today because I can't sleep right now because I'm really worried about my uncle right now because my uncle is in ICU right now in the emergency room because he's got heart problems and my uncle doesn't have much longer to live. My uncle could die at any minute, so I'm going to visit my uncle tomorrow at the hospital. We're gonna go up north to visit my uncle in the hospital, so I'm hoping I can say goodbye to my uncle one last time before he passes away. It's really depressing and sad, but yeah, I'm just kind of playing FIFA right now, trying to kill time until I can go visit my uncle tomorrow because I can't sleep because I'm really worried about my uncle right now. So I feel bad for my dad because, like, My grandma passed away, which is my dad's mom. My dad's parents basically both passed away because of old age. And my uncle, which is my dad's brother, it's the only family my dad's got left, really, in his intermediate family. So I feel really bad for my dad. I feel really bad for my dad because, you know, once he loses his brother, all he's got is me and my sister. And a few other people in the family, of course. So I'm just worried about how hard my dad's gonna take this. Because my uncle is a really cool guy. I love my uncle because he's a really cool guy. So yeah, I'm gonna tell my dad what happened in the morning, so my dad knows what's going on with his brother. And I'm hoping my uncle will be okay, but I mean, it could go either way, because my uncle had a near-death experience, like, I don't know, maybe 2 or 3 years ago, because my uncle used to be a smoker. He used to smoke all his life. He used to smoke cigarettes his whole life. So he ended up getting lung cancer, or he was showing early signs of lung cancer. He had a 50-50 chance of living. He was very lucky. He survived.
They put that cross far too close to the goalkeeper.
So the guy, so my uncle had a 50-50 chance to live. He survived. He got lucky. He actually survived the surgery that they gave him. They had to give my uncle life-saving surgery, but he came through. He came through in the end, but now 2 years later, after all those lung problems he had, we're suspecting that the lung cancer he had connected to the heart problems he's having right now. So for all we know, we don't know how long my uncle's got left, so we all want to go visit my uncle one last time. That way, should he for some reason pass away, we can say that we can say we were there for my uncle in his final hours. We want to be able to really just want a chance to say goodbye to my uncle before he dies, because last two or three family members that died in my family, I didn't get a chance to say goodbye, and that's like the hardest thing when you want to say goodbye to a family member and you don't get a chance to say goodbye. It can definitely be stressful. It can really hurt sometimes, but yeah, I'm just trying to hang tough for now. I'm just trying to hang tough today. Just trying to get through the day. Just trying to get through the week. Hoping my uncle will be okay. I'm hoping that when I go to visit my uncle tomorrow, I'm hoping the doctor will have some kind of good news. I'm hoping, but you never really know when, you know, when people are dying, you never know. Yeah, no problem, Andy. You're welcome. I don't mind streaming. Yeah, you're welcome. I also made this stream too because I wanted to support the. I know the in Dallas they had some shootings going on in Dallas, and I really just want to make this stream so I can support the city of Dallas in their tough time that they're going through right now too. There was a shooting. There were five police officers that got shot in Dallas. And I just wanted to make a tribute to the Dallas Police Force, make this video a tribute to them, so. Oh yeah, and thanks for the kind words that you said about my uncle. Thank you for the kind words. I appreciate your kind words. Thank you. It definitely means a lot to me. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. I really do. The kind words go a long way. I appreciate it. Thank you. Thanks, Andy. I appreciate it. Thanks, man. Thank you. But yeah, and that's the other thing this stream is for too, is supporting the Dallas Police Force, because it was really tragic and sad what happened in Dallas with the five police officers that got shot. It was really tragic and sad. So I really wanted to also wanted to make this stream dedicated to the Dallas Police Force and dedicate this to all the people that were affected from the protesting, all the people that were wrongfully hurt. I just want those people to know I'm thinking about them. Thinking about all those families, all the Dallas Police Force families. Just want them to know I'm thinking about them. I'm sending prayers their way. Just want God to bless the families of the five police officers. Bless the whole city of Dallas. Hopefully, bless my uncle and help my uncle get through this tough time. Bless everybody that was involved in the two shootings of the innocent African Americans in Minnesota and Louisiana. You know, prayers go out to them, to the two African American victims that were affected by the crisis when they died in police custody. This video goes out to them too. This is a tribute to them and the families of those victims. I just want you to know we're thinking about you, and we're thinking about your family members. We're thinking about all of you. May all those people rest in peace. May they be at peace. May they be in a better place in heaven, hopefully. And I'm thinking about all of you. I'm thinking about all the people that were hurt lately. So I hope you all get better, or can get better and get through this tough time. And I hope everybody can get well soon. God bless everybody. God bless everybody. So just want y'all to know I'm thinking about you. We don't want any more bad things happening in the U.S. We want things to get better. We want things to get better. But yep, that's the reason I made this stream though. I hope you guys are doing well, by the way. I know I'm kind of talking a lot. Sorry about that. Just have a lot on my mind today. But thanks for watching my stream today. Thank you. And we can talk about whatever you guys would like to talk about. Just message me what you want to talk about. We can talk about anything you want, really. So, anyways. Who did you guys root for? So, Andy, who did you root for in UEFA Euro, the European soccer tournament? What country were you rooting for? I know Portugal won the tournament. They won the tournament, but I'm just curious what countries you were supporting. If there's any countries that you wanted to win the whole thing. Maybe one more game though, because I'm getting a little bit fatigued right now. But I'll play one more just for you guys that are watching right now. I'll play one more for you guys, just so I can try to give you another game here. Yeah, thanks, man. I appreciate the kind words. Thanks, man. I appreciate the nice gesture. Thank you very much. And I want the city of Dallas, and I want the rest of the United States of America, the citizens in the U.S. Just everybody. I want everybody to stay strong through these difficult times, through all these riots and protesting going on. You know, just want everybody to stay strong no matter what. I know things are getting tough in the United States right now, and we got this really big election going on, and people are worried about the future of the country. I understand completely. I just want everybody to stay strong and not ever give up in life. I mean, we still gotta try to enjoy life, right? You only live once. You gotta enjoy life the best you can, because you don't know what the future's gonna bring you. So, you know, anytime you get a chance to hang out with your family, anytime you get a chance to hang out with a family member and just spend time with them, definitely do it. And anytime you get to hang out with your friends or go on vacation somewhere, anytime you get a chance to spend valuable family time with people, you get a chance to enjoy life, always take the opportunity to do it. Life's always about the people you spend it with. Material possessions don't mean anything. Material possessions mean nothing at all to me. And I think as an entire planet, we need to work on caring about other people more than objects. I think it seems like people just care more about money than anything. So my advice to the world is just cherish each other. Just enjoy each other's company. Enjoy each other. Try to make friends in the world. Make friends. Have fun together, build relationships, and enjoy life. That's what life's all about. Life's all about the people you spend your time with. That's what matters. So, you know, if people are, you know, people get in fights about who owes, you know, people get in fights about money, people get in fights about politics, I ask those people to put their differences aside. Don't worry about, don't let money or politics affect your friendships or your family relationships. Just be there for your family and friends, and just enjoy life. You know, you never know what the future's going to bring you. So, just cherish everybody that you're around. Just cherish people. And enjoy life as much as you can, because you never know when your time to go is, really. So, and you don't want to spend your whole life looking back and regretting that you didn't do certain things in your life. You don't want to spend your whole life regretting that you got in a fight with somebody, and you know you hold a lifelong grudge with somebody. You don't want to spend your whole life regretting that you didn't make up and you didn't say you were sorry. You don't want to spend your whole life, you know, with life grudges, so. Yeah, my advice to people, though, in the world, build friendships. Hang out with people anytime you can. You know, spend time with your family. And just cherish people that you know. Even if it's a total stranger, you know, even if you're helping out a total stranger for 5 to 10 minutes, you know, you're helping a stranger get through the day and they're having a rough day and you see someone's having a tough time, you know, pay it forward. Help people out. Let's make the world a better place. I don't think God ever wanted us to live in fear or to fear other people in the world. So just love each other, cherish each other, and let's make the world a better place. Let's make the world a better place to live in. That's what I think that's what God would want. So that's what I would want too. So
here comes the support.
That's all I'm going to say about that, though. Just want to get that message across to people that watch this stream. Just enjoy life. I try to tell my friends that, too, because, yeah, I mean, especially with your older family members, you know, like, with, like, kind of like my uncle, for example. My uncle's, you know, my uncle's dying, and I don't know if I'm going to see him again, so I'm going to go see him tomorrow so I get a chance to see him one more time. That's what life's about, really. Getting to spend time with your family members while they're alive. I know. You know how sometimes it gets, though. Like, you know, life can get busy sometimes. I understand that, too, though. I really do understand that completely. Life can get busy. It can be harder to hang out with people because you just have a busy lifestyle. But you just gotta do what you gotta do to make time for your family.
Possession in the midfield area.
Just gotta make time for people. But, you do the best you can, you know? You just do the best you can. What you got. And, Dallas Police Department. Uncle Bob. Frank. You're in my prayers tonight. James. And I hope you all get well. I hope you all can get through this difficult time. And be careful out there, Dallas Police. Be safe out there. Have each other's backs out there. This world is a scary and dangerous place. So, Dallas Police Department, take care of each other out there. And don't worry, Dallas Police. We have your back. I have your back. I know my uncle was a police officer, so, and I have people in my family, and I have family and friends that are police officers, so, I totally understand how tough it, I totally understand from what I've been told in my family and through friends that were police officers, I totally understand how tough it is to be a cop, and, Dallas Police Department, I just wanna show you my thanks and gratitude. Thank you for helping out. Thank you for protecting and serving the city of Dallas, and we appreciate the service that you do for the city of Dallas. Thank you for your hard work and your bravery. It's very honorable what you do, and we just wanna show thanks for all you've done. So thanks for thank you for the service that you have provided. And police officers in general, this is a shout out to you guys. You guys are awesome. Shout out to the police officers all over the world, every country. Shout out to you guys. Thank you for protecting and serving your communities out there and making the world a safer place. Thank you. We appreciate it.
Chris Smalling. Here's Kim. Good support play from his teammates.
That's very good.
good link at play. Tremendous understanding.
It could be a chance.
Well, that's a shame for him because he's gone into good position so far in this game.
Well, he wears his heart on his sleeve, this lad, and having missed several chances, look at him, absolutely furious with himself.
Impressive attacking play here from Manchester United.
Now the shot! He scored! And that is a contender for goal of the season without question. To find the left corner from that distance.
It's Manchester United in the lead.
Shut the stream down pretty soon.
That's very comfortable for the keeper here. Of an equalising goal. And that will end the threat, at least for the moment. Well, that's a good challenge between the two of them there. Well, this is half time. Teams back out for the second half. Invitational Cup group stage. It's a free kick. It's a yellow card. It was a certain yellow card, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think so. Looking back on it, he had no choice at all.
Good work by the goalkeeper. He saw the free kick coming. Damian.
Man, this game, up 2-1. You guys got any suggestions? What do you think I should do differently? I know I'm kind of playing like crap today, to be honest. Do you think I should change my formation up? Should I try to put some different players in? Maybe, you know, switch up the rotation a little bit? What do you guys think I should do?
If you look at the coaching manual,
and shoots! Oh, he hasn't hit the target. Here's Kim. Some potential in this move. Could get his cross in now. He's put him in! Punch. And the cross is in. He's got it away. Well, they put the buy into Bayern again with this transfer deal.
Well, 35 million or thereabouts. Isn't a small figure, but loads of potential with this lad.
Subs getting ready. Manchester United have won the ball back here. good block.
Dang it.
He's coming forward with some danger. Here's Kip.
Now the shot!
Equalizer.
Alrighty. I don't need this anymore. I don't need this anymore because I'm not in a party chat anymore. So. Alrighty.
Cut off! And the goalkeeper got a touch to that. Fine save.
Oh, come on, he saved that? Come on, bruh. I guess we... Oh, look at that, he steals it! Oh, he saved it again. Good save, good save. Just barely saved it. I thought that was going in. I really thought that was a goal there. He missed it. Just missed it to the right. When it just a little bit left, that was going.
First touch was good, but he's got to work hard to keep the ball. Here's Yang. Attacking now. Very good passing from this team. Gonna cross it. Danger was looming large. They've got themselves back on the ball and they can attack themselves now. It'll be a corner.
Hello and thank you for watching my stream today. Welcome. Thank you for watching.
That's not a good corner.
Unless
at all.
Unless you're the same people that were watching before, in that case, my bad. Sorry. I just can't tell who's watching, but yeah, thanks for watching my stream.
Here.
Give him a yellow, do something.
Now James.
Ah,
making decisions in key areas of the game. That wasn't a very good decision to shoot from there.
Well, collective groans right there in this stadium and some looks of disgust from teammates.
Teammates.
Now it's gotta be a corner
on the attack again. The team that's leading by one goal.
The shot's up. He's just reached it. The goalkeeper.
United with the ball again.
There we go.
He's got his shot off now. He's kept it out.
Good save.
Kim.
Man, this team has got no offense.
Up went the flag. Offside given.
That's definitely an offside, yeah.
Ricky.
Come on, go and get that, go and get that. Ah, he beat me to the punch.
Towards the end of the 90 minutes, 9 minutes left.
Come on, let's get another goal. Let's score another goal here.
Now the shot!
Oh, I missed another one. Dang it. I keep getting close. Just no cigar.
Ricky.
stopped by the goalkeeper.
Oh, come on, ref. The goalie got in my way of the header. And that's not a penalty? Pretty sure when a goalie gets in the way of a scorer, that should definitely be a penalty shot.
Race to try and hit it now. Oh, so close. Hit the crossbar.
So we got 4 minutes to go here. Nobody is wide open here. We got a foul cross at them.
Here's Kim. On to the attack now. Here's the cross. Goes for it with a fist.
And we'll let the ball go.
A quick throw on here to get them on the attack. There goes the cross. Well, he's cleared the danger. We want to keep the opposition pen back. This throw can help do that. Oh, in goes the cross. He can hit it here. Well, they've got to take this risk now for
you
the
have
corner.
A corner, but I'm not giving you an easy goal.
And he goes for goal with his head. Oh, the goalkeeper's relieved to get that. That looked a chance. And here comes
come on, breakaway, breakaway, breakaway. Let's go, 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 let's go.
And here's the shot. That's a brilliant goal.
And that's what happens when you overplay the net, goalie. I get a freebie. That was a nice cross for the easy goal.
The scorer
goalie's like, oh no!
Get the goal quite like this one. Couldn't really believe his luck.
No, and the keeper's going to get some stick in that dressing room afterwards because, well, where on earth was he?
Easiest goal ever.
Well, I want to see this again, this goal. 3-1 the scoreline as we restart the game.
Thanks for watching the stream. This is gonna be the last stream, but thank you all for watching. I appreciate you watching. Thank you so much. And thoughts and prayers go out to the city of Dallas. Thoughts and prayers go out to the city of Dallas, the Dallas Police Department, and thoughts and prayers go out to the victims in Minnesota and Louisiana. So thoughts and prayers go to all those victims. So yeah. Thoughts and prayers. God bless all of you. And I hope you all can stay strong and can get through this crisis. So, God, please watch over these people and help them get through these difficult times. And, please help my uncle out too, if possible. If not, I understand. Thoughts and prayers go out to everybody. Thank you for watching my stream, and have a good night, everybody.